Hello, I'm Ron Delong, artist in studio and gallery 2908. Today we're going to focus on continuing a series of lessons that I've started that are designed specifically for adults who want to learn how to draw, who have not drawn in their life, beginning artists. And in lesson number one, I talked about using the element of line and shape. And I added an addendum to lesson number one. And in lesson number two, I talked about value, which is another art element that is useful in creating the illusion of form on a two-dimensional surface. And in that lesson, I helped explain to students, or I explained to them, how to create value and developing a value scale, and then having that value applied to a simple shape that was drawn with curved lines created the illusion of a sphere. We've been using this particular object that we've been looking at, or I've been looking at. It's a beeswax finial, and the reason I chose this object is because of its stacked line and shape and its stacked forms. So in order to create this illusion of form, we have to analyze the work for its line and shape first, and once we have a line and shape drawing that is adequate, we can then apply value, varying degrees of value, onto the line and shapes to create the illusion of form. Now, I've gone ahead and I have started working on putting and applying value, graphite value. Specifically, I use a number 8B pencil. The 8B pencil is useful because I like it. It helps you to draw lightly and to also push hard on it to draw very, very dark values. So for my preference, I know that they make many, many different levels of value in graphite, but I prefer to use for fine art drawing the 6B to 9B graphite in order to create my drawing. As you see here in the drawing that I've started, this was actually the line and shape drawing that I created. And now you see I have applied varying degrees of lights and darks to the object, looking at the object. So I observe where the lights and darks appear on the particular object, and then I replicate that or render that into the line and shape design that I originally had drawn. Now, I've taken this and I also use the pencil, and when I'm applying value, I use it by holding the pencil at the end and kind of developing a hatching effect where I go back and forth and back and forth, and it's a spontaneous application of the graphite to the paper. I do that then a little more carefully inside the forms, and I'm looking back and forth. Now, it's important to understand this, that when you are creating a drawing, each time you look at an object, that object is important to analyze and carefully observe where the lights and darks are on that object that is lit with a light source. But I find that a lot of times students will set up their workstation where they have to move their head back and forth and back and forth, and then they lose their spot or they lose their place. It's a good idea or a suggestion to help remedy that would be to position your still life or your objects that you're drawing so that all you have to do is look at the object and move your eyes back and forth, because you'll have an opportunity to look carefully but not lose your spot when you're looking back and forth from your paper to the object. That being said, I want to address some of the tools and the materials that can help you apply value to your line drawing. Now, as I said, I'm using a 8B pencil, and pencils usually are coated at the end. There is a number and a letter, and I sometimes sharpen my pencil with an X-Acto knife. I know that people use either electric sharpeners or they use handheld sharpeners. Oftentimes, I prefer to use an X-Acto knife and whittle away the wood and use that graphite pencil. And also be mindful that when you're sharpening your pencil, you wanna make sure that you have the wood far away from the edge of the tool so that it doesn't score or leave marks on the paper that are difficult to remove. So you see here that I have applied value. Another tool that I use is a graphite stick that is woodless. This has just graphite in it, and that's useful for applying a graphite to large areas. It comes in stick forms, and then it also comes in block form as well. So I use this graphite if I'm covering large areas. Another tool that is useful is something called a blending stump. This is a piece of paper, well, it's paper, it's wrapped paper, and it has a point to it at both ends. And this is used to go into your work and to push and pull the graphite around the surface or the support of the paper. Now, be mindful that you can't sharpen these. You should not sharpen them. It just doesn't make sense to sharpen it. But I typically will keep my graphite blending stumps separate from charcoal blending stumps or pastel blending stumps, et cetera, et cetera. I keep it separate. So I have blending stumps. Another tool that I keep handy is some kind of brush. The brush is used to brush away crumbs in case you're using this tool, which is an eraser. An eraser is a drawing tool. It's not used just to make mistakes. In some instances, you have to go into your drawing to remove some of the graphite from the drawing, and that is considered a subtractive drawing process. Anytime we put marks on the paper, we're adding. Anytime we remove marks from the paper, we're subtracting. So you have both subtractive and additive processes in the drawing experience. And I use the brush to brush away any crumbs that may appear, because if I take my hand, which has oil on it, and I brush it, I will wind up smearing it. Also be mindful that if you blow at it and you get saliva on your paper, oftentimes that saliva is gonna leave a mark and it's gonna be challenging to remove that mark that you've created with the saliva on the surface. Here's another tool that is useful. You can get these, they're soft, they're handles with very, very soft foam rubber ends. And they're useful for helping to push value around and to get soft effects inside the object to create that gradual transition of light and dark in your particular object. And finally, we have something here called a chamois cloth. A chamois cloth is a piece of leather, and it's been, you might know this, people use these to wash their vehicles or their cars. Artists use this, and you can go in here and you can take some of this and spread the graphite around a little more effectively and more quickly using a chamois cloth. But you have to be careful, because sometimes a chamois cloth may take some of the graphite and remove the graphite, subtract it from the surface of the paper. So you have all of these tools which are useful in creating the graphite. And again, be mindful that you need to look back and forth from the object that you're drawing with a light source on it, because if you look at this, you're gonna see there's highlight areas here, there's highlight areas here. With the light source, there's darker areas here. And if you put this against a dark background, you're gonna see strong contrast. So typically I like to use my objects and light them to dramatize the lights and dark values that I see and observe in the still life or the object, and then work to correlate that with what I'm putting on the paper. And finally, with graphite, because it's an oil-based material, another tool that I have is a simple brush. And if you take some solvent, I use terpenoid, but you can use other solvents. Because graphite has oil in it, you can go in here and you can use this to push the graphite around on the paper to get an even effect. And you'll see that I've done that on this side, and the streakiness of the line work disappears, and it gives you a more even covering of the graphite that I applied to the surface of the paper. So this particular video addresses many of the tools that are useful to help the beginning adult who wants to learn how to draw well to draw, because drawing is not just necessarily taking a pencil and putting marks on a paper. There are other useful tools that'll help you improve your drawing skills. That's lesson four. Stay tuned for lesson five, where I'm going to talk about color and the application of color using the same finial. And I hope you have a very good drawing experience. Okay, goodbye.